Hi, Dave Spaulding, and what I want to talk to you about today is being willing. I've never hidden the fact that, in my opinion, the most essential of essential skills is having a combative mindset. And that's basically defined as making a previous decision to be ready and willing to fight. I break down the mindset, having that combative mindset, as awareness and willingness. Willingness comes into play when you were not able to avoid or evade the fight, which is certainly a byproduct of awareness. But when it comes down to being willing, I've never heard it defined better than from an old John Wayne movie called The Shootist. He's talking to a young stable boy played by Ron Howard, who realizes that the old gunfighter isn't that good of a shot. And when he asks him about it, he looks at him and he says, "Friend, there's nobody up there shooting back at you." It's not about being accurate or even fast. It's about being willing. I found out early that most men, regardless of cause or need, aren't willing. They'll blink an eye or draw a breath before they pull the trigger, and I won't. Former Special Forces operator Kyle Lamb even took it a step further when he defined the good combat shooter as the person that was still shooting back when bullets were coming in his direction. The fact of the matter is that the person who is willing to enter a situation in which they may lose their life is a formidable opponent, whether they can shoot an X-ring at 25 yards or they can draw and fire a gun in 1 second. The biggest difference is that person will step into the arena knowing that maybe they're not as fast or as accurate as the person they're facing and do it anyway. In my opinion, armed conflict is really more about 10% skill and about 90% attitude. And I have to ask you, while you're training, do you have that attitude? Because you know what? You can develop that mindset when you are drawing that or practicing that fast draw or that reload. Are you imaging that steel plate that's out in front of you is someone trying to kill you? Or are you just imaging it as a steel plate? There's a big difference. You see, because when it comes down to saving your life, the life of a family member, or the life of a friend, it's not going to be so much about what your shooting skills are, or how good you look, or how you've dressed, or whether you got the latest gun, or the fanciest holster, or you're following the latest training trends. It's going to come down to, do you have the commitment to do whatever it takes, no matter how distasteful, to prevail? And it's been my personal experience over the last 30 plus years that most people do not. And when you come across that person that does, you recognize it. And that, my friends, is what I would want you to develop. That commitment to doing whatever it takes, no matter what, to prevail. And it may be just being willing to train and practice at your own time and on your own time and your own dime. And I see so many people that, yeah, I'm not paying for that training course or I don't have the time to do that. Well, if you don't have the time and money to prepare to save your own life, then what's important?
Pantio.